नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ जेबी एंड डॉक्टर अरुण कुमार सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मैथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माई डिजिटल क्लास एंड ऑफ थर्ड सेमेस्टर। वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक एलिमेंट्री एजुकेशन एज हाईलाइटेड इन प्रोग्राम ऑफ एक्शन POA 1992। POA UN National Policy of Education 1986 began to be implemented in country. It was opposed to non-Congress parties, but then Prime Minister Sri Rajiv Gandhi continued with its implementation. The committee was set up under the chairmanship of Acharya Ram Murthy in May 1990 to review NPE and to make recommendations for its modifications. Then Chandrasekhar becomes Prime Minister in November 1990. He allowed committee to continue its work and submit its report on 26 December 1990. The report was had to be debated in the parliament when once again Congress came into power and wanted to implement NPE 1986 in its original form, but Ramamurthy committee reports was lying for considerations. Okay, so the central government constitutes another committees or Central Advisory Board of Education under the chairmanship of Sri N. Janardana Reddy, which submitted its report in January 1992. Thereafter, HRD Minister Sri Arjun Singh presented the revised National Policy of Education in the Parliament on May 1992. POA under NPE 1986 envisioned to conduct of common entrance examination on all India basis of admission and professional and technical programs in the country. Objectives of POA 1992: education must play a positive and interventionist role in correcting social and regional imbalance, empowering women and in securing rightful place for the disadvantaged and the minorities. Features of POA: role of education. Education is responsible for the all around development of the individuals. Education is the right of life, and education pupils can develop their knowledge and skill through education. National system of education: common education structure 10+2+3 for whole of India, and it is that system which is in accordance with the national needs and its appraisals. Education for quality, equality. This policy provides equal opportunity to all for education. Navodaya school have been opened not only for socially and economically deprived but also for talented children. Education for scheduled castes includes equalization of scheduled caste population with others in matter of education, ensured by giving incentives to parents who send their children schools. Scholarship, hostel facilities, adult education programs are being introduced. Women's education: new education policy gave special emphasis to women education. This set statements was that women are the key of nation's progresses. Education for tribes: this policy gave main emphasis to the education of tribes. Residential ashram schools have been opened for them. Scholarships for higher educations are given. Adult education in instances of nation literacy missions for teaching literate pupils of age group 15 to 35 years. For this, adult schools, library, distance education, TV programs are being introduced. Early childhood education, special emphasis on early childhood care and education by opening up of daycare centers, promotion of child promotions programs, and resulting in all around development of children. And next, it is a feeder and support for primary education. So, education for minorities in pursuance of the revised program of action 1992, two new centrally sponsored schemes. Firstly, scheme of area intensive program for education by ground minorities, and scheme of financial assistance of modernization of madrasa education. Operation Blackboard. The purpose of Operation Blackboard is to be ensure provisions of minimum essential facility in primary schools. The word operation implies that there is an urgency in these programs, that goals are clear and well defined. Primary education or elementary education. Often in primary education or elementary education is typically the first stage of compulsory education, coming between clearly childhood education and secondary education. It provides a common platform for students, and it shall be ensured that free and compulsory education or of satisfactory quality is provided to children up to 14 years of age before we enter 21st century. Advantage of Indian education system. By comparing with other countries, only in India every student have a basic knowledge about all the subjects. Only school in India follow the regular attendance methods, so that students will gain basic knowledge about their daily habitations of life needs, and students go through many exams in their learning years. It teaches them to analyze their own strength and weakness, consistency. Conclusions of POA 1992. Now a day, lots of positive changes are happening in the education system of India. There is a definite need of re-evaluatory changes in the Indian education system. With the effective learning system, India can successfully utilize its vast human resources, and by that the dream of our youngest hero Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Dream of India 2020, will get success. Okay, thank you students.